Hello students, let us continue the lesson. Ekalavya.
Now Dronacharya refuses to teach Ekalavya. Ekalavya took Dronacharya's blessings and leaves away. Now the scene 2. This is the forest scene. 2 years later, Drona's idol decorated with flowers on a platform under a tree. Ekalavya bowing before the idol and some deer grazing peacefully at a distance. This is a scene where Drona's idol is kept and he is bowing near in front of the idol. Ekalavya. Now Ekalavya addressing the idol, he says, "Great Acharya, how kind you are. You have taught me archery well within these 2 years. What good luck is mine to have you as my guru. I have achieved my goal. My dear fawns are now free from trouble." Looking at the deer in the distance, how peacefully they are grazing. Now can you see the picture? Now he had learned archery only by keeping the idol of Dronacharya. Now he says his fawns are now free from trouble. Ekalavya says, Ekalavya hears the barking sound of dogs at a distance. Now he hears the sound of dogs barking. Ha, this is not the howl of wolves. The sound is coming nearer. The deer lift up their heads in fear and run to him. Have no fear, my dear animals. No dog or wolf shall disturb your peace as long as I live. Now he had learned the archery of the trick Shabdavedi. Now there was a howl of wolves. Now the deer lift up their heads and they ran towards him. Now he said that no need to worry. No dog or wolf shall disturb your peace as long as I live. He shoots arrows in the direction of the barking. The sound stops. Now this is the Shabdavedi trick. Oh, quite a big party of hunters. How wicked they are to set their dogs against the innocent animals of the forest. Oh, what do I see, my guru with his pupils. Now he had seen a howl of wolves coming towards, now running after the deer. Now he had shot the arrow to them. The sound stops in the direction of the barking. Without seeing the howl of the wolves, he had shot the arrow. Now he sees some pupils were coming. That was his guru Dronacharya and his pupils. Enter Drona with Arjuna and other princes and a dog with arrows in its mouth. The poor dog whines helplessly. Ekalavya prostrates before Drona. Enter Drona with Arjuna and other princes and a dog with arrows in its mouth. Ekalavya sees Drona with Arjuna and other disciples and a dog with arrows in its mouth. Now the poor dog whines helplessly. Ekalavya prostrates before Drona. He again bows in front of Dronacharya. Ekalavya says, "Acharya, Ekalavya, the son of Hiranyadhanus, pays his respects to you." Now he introduces himself again. Now Drona says, "Arise, my boy, God bless you. What a skill you have gained in archery in this short period. Your teacher must indeed be a great one." Now he was surprised to see the skill of Ekalavya. He has shot the arrow in the mouth of the dog without hurting it. So Arjuna, really, this boy has mastered the art of shooting arrows by detecting the source of sound. That is Shabdavedi. By seeing Ekalavya's skillful trick, Drona appreciated him. Ekalavya's skill was uncomparable. It was an extraordinary skill, Drona says. Yes, when Arjuna appreciated this skill of Ekalavya, Ekalavya says, "It is all the result of your blessings, great Acharya. I learnt all the tricks of archery under your kind guidance. Only with the blessings of Dronacharya he had learnt this archery. How kind of you to visit this poor abode of your humble pupil, Ekalavya says. Arjuna says now, Acharya, you promised to make me the greatest archer in the world. But here is a boy who excels me and he says you are his guru. Now Arjuna reminds Drona that Drona had promised to make Arjuna the greatest archer in the world. But what is here? How has the Ekalavya learned the archery? According to Drona, Ekalavya became a good archer by his devotion. His devotion only made him good archer. Now Drona says, Arjuna, you know I have been with you always. It is the devotion of this boy that has made him a good bowman. Let us end up here. We'll continue in the next class. Thank you.